All right, so I'm here right now with the King of Random in probably one of the coolest shops I've ever seen.
What's up, guys? Welcome to my laboratory.
For real, that's exactly what it is. This desk is phenomenal. It's got so many power tools. But there's one special thing that I want to show you, and it blew my mind when I saw it for the first time.
Nobody knows about this yet. This is kind of like behind the scenes.
Top secret.
Pre-video video.
Okay, so liquid nitrogen, why do you need it?
Why do you need liquid nitrogen? Well, yes. Why do I need liquid nitrogen, or why does the world need liquid nitrogen?
You, particularly.
Me, particularly, I like liquid nitrogen just for playing around. It's fun to play with because it can make things explode, it can make things freeze. It's one of those substances where it has properties that you don't typically find in normal everyday living because it's so cold, and the amount of energy that it takes to make it that cold, it's not readily accessible. Not very many people know where to find liquid nitrogen. And so it's just one of those cool things. It's also very dangerous. It could freeze your hands off. It could kill you. So I'm very much intrigued by things that could possibly kill you.
Which is weird because it can kill you, it can freeze your hands off, but here we are in the basement of the King of Random's house. So show us how...
Nobody needs to know that.
Show us how you make liquid nitrogen.
Okay, I'm gonna run you very, very briefly through the process of how I'm making liquid nitrogen right now. And if you listen very, very carefully, you can hear a tinking noise in the background. Clunk, 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 clunk. Let me show you what that noise is. And over here, this is what we're working on today. Me and Zach, you're gonna see this popping up on my channel, but we have been playing with brains. Gummy brains, coming soon. This is a spare room that I set up. It used to be a guest bedroom. Now I use it for my radiator. Which is right down here. Now this is basically just a giant glorified radiator that I built with a friend of mine named Chris. We have a radiator here, we have water pumping in through it, and it's being cooled by a giant furnace fan that's pumping air out the back. So air gets sucked in here, cools the water down, blows out here, and I put a little mesh screen guard in this so my kids can't reach in and chop their fingers off. We have a window open because this thing gets really hot, and this circulates all the air. So what we're doing is we're bringing in hot water, cooling it down, pumping that hot air off, and then sending back cold water to what I'm about to show you next. And here is what we have making that ticking noise. This is a cryo cooler powered by helium. I'll tell you about how that works in just a second. See this little thing bumping up and down? That's very important. So this is the really crude setup I've got going on right now. It's just what we have to work with. This is my nitrogen generator. This is my nitrogen tank. And this thing here is called a helium compressor. And that's what's pumping helium to the cryo head and back. This is the stuff that gets really, really hot. This is the stuff that turns nitrogen into liquid nitrogen. So our atmosphere that we're living in is about 79% nitrogen. So nitrogen is all around us. What this little machine here does is it takes the nitrogen out of the air, it pulls the oxygen out of it, and then cleans it so that it's a nice dry gas. Dry nitrogen. At that point, we pump it into this tank where I can pressurize it and hold the tank full of nitrogen. Now, I have a little regulator on here, and this regulator just allows me to pump that gas out at about 1 psi. It travels through this poly tube, which runs over to the dewar and just gently vents the gas on a very, very cold heat sink. And that's the tube that you see right here. Now, the second system, this is where the water and the radiator come in. I have a helium compressor here that compresses helium, and you know, as a gas is compressed, it heats up. Well, that cools down, we run that helium over to this cryo head, and the whole purpose of the cryo head is to pump the gas in there and then rapidly expand it. And as it expands, it gets very, very cold and sucks heat out of the dewar. The hot helium gas runs back to the helium compressor where it's liquid cooled with water, and I'm pumping that water back up to the radiator to cool it back down so it can come back down and repeat the process. So this thing right here is just a glorified air conditioner that gets so cold that when you push nitrogen gas onto it, it condenses and starts dripping down into the dewar.
And so with all this system in place, how long would it take for this system to fill up with liquid nitrogen?
So you gotta think, we're just putting it in one drop at a time. So this is a 35 liter dewar. It's gonna take about 2 to 3 weeks for it to fill up completely. But we've already got about 15, well, how much do we have in there? I think it's about half full right now, so we're probably somewhere around 20 liters. And to fill this thing up completely would cost me about $170. So making a it at home, I don't know if it really saves a whole lot of money, but who else is making liquid nitrogen at home? I just think it's cool.
It's a cool novelty effect.
So you pretty much have an endless supply of liquid nitrogen, right?
Yeah, because we live in nitrogen. We're just cooling it down and turning it into a liquid, that's all.
Yeah, because there's nitrogen in the air that we breathe.
That's right. In fact, if I just let it running, if I let this thing just keep running without the nitrogen generator, I would basically just be making liquid atmosphere, which would be a nitrogen and oxygen. And I could use this liquid nitrogen to make liquid oxygen. Basically make any kind of variety of gases or liquids that we want. It's just really effective, and it's great for cooling things down quickly.
That's interesting. You also mentioned that there's helium inside of that machine. So is the helium ever used up? Like, you have to replenish that, or is the system completely like self-sustained?
Good question. Now, the helium compressor is a closed system. So all it's doing is it's taking that helium, it's compressing it, and then it's going through a heat exchanger to cool that gas down. And then it's running out to the cryo head where it expands and heats up again, and then runs back, and it just repeats that process. It's just exchanging heat, like just like your air conditioning unit does in your house. This is just on a much higher level and a lot more expensive.
So as long as it has electricity, it can keep making liquid nitrogen forever.
Yep. As long as there are no leaks in the helium compressor, that helium will stay in there in a closed loop system indefinitely.
That's impressive. It's also impressive that he jerry-rigged that whole system right here in his basement.
That all came from 3 years of trying to find parts and piece them together from university surplus, eBay, Amazon, all over the place. But we finally got it working. This is my second batch of liquid nitrogen. The first batch I used to freeze a heart on my channel, and we smashed it.
Oh,
and
that was cool.
We kind of dissected a heart with liquid nitrogen. So another abnormal use for it, but that's how I roll.
That's cool.
And I will actually have a full tutorial on this liquid nitrogen generator going into a little bit more depth of how it works on my channel in the near future. So
cool.
If you want to come check me out, King of Random on YouTube.
Nice.
I have some cool content for you.
Thanks for giving us a behind the scenes look. I was very, very impressed. Go check out his channel. I'll leave a link in the video description below, and right up here in this section, I'll show you what we've been working on here on his counter. Thanks, Steph, for watching. I'll see you around.